Hello guys, good morning or good afternoon, depende kung anong oras natin ma-upload itong lecture natin ngayon, no? So, yesterday guys, no, I posted doon sa ating Facebook page, no, as well as dito sa ating community post, dito sa ating YouTube channel, no, about the topic that we will be lecturing for today, no? And we asked, no, if, kasi, in the recent events, kasi we know naman the politics are coming, no? Yung mga politicians are, they're being asked, no, about their future plans, no, for the country once that they will be elected as either president or vice president, senator, something like that in the year 2022, no, yung taong ngayong election. So, isa sa pumukaw ng ating pansin was the statement of vice presidential aspirant, no, Mayor Inday Sara, no, where she wanted, or she pointed out that she wanted to make it, no, yung make it the military service as mandatory for those who are 18. No, years old, yeah, those individuals who are under 18, para sa mga individual na nasa 18 years of age, no? So that is quite interesting topic, ano, for this matter, kasi I know that this will be a big issue, no, pag talagang nasimulan na, no, nagawin or pa nasimulan na na totohanin, no, itong idea na ito, making military service as mandatory, no, for all Filipino citizens. Okay? So I know that may mga issues na tayo when it comes to ROTC pa lang, ano? So how much more, no, how would they intake this mandatory military service? Okay? I think, ano, most of those individual na nag-comment sa ating Facebook post, no, yung mga estudyante natin, hello pala kay ano, Kenneth, tapos kay Mr. Wanawan, siya kasi ano, sino pa, si Briones, no, yung former student natin sa PLT, no, they commented that they agree, no, with the idea of mandatory military service. I know na it is expected since you are in the criminology course, no, degree, so expected yan, no, that you from the criminology schools, no, are really in favor of this. But no, bago natin siya sabihin na okay tayo dito, no, I think it's first necessary for us to talk about what should appear in the law once that they wanted to make it mandatory, no. Baka naman mamaya is may singit sila dito, no, na hindi naman katanggap-tanggap. Me, myself, no, I agree with the idea of mandatory military service, pero I have reservation, no, hindi naman totally agree, no. I mean, it depends upon the provisions nung batas na gagawin nila that will mandate the mandatory military service for Filipino citizen, no. Kasi I know who will be affected by this, no, yung mga kapatid natin, no, yung mga anak natin, kayo mga anak na kayo, no, yung mga individual, no, na lalaki pa lang, kumbaga, no, tayo eh malapit na tayo mapaglipasan ng kalendaryo, eh kumbaga hindi na tayo masasaklaw, kumbaga, nito, so parang feel safe ka na, something like that. Pero this is for the future of those of our loved ones, no, na pwedeng ito yung maabutan nilang patakaran, no. So medyo ano, pasensya na guys, ha? Medyo namamalat tayo ngayon, eh. Medyo hindi magandang pakiramdam natin, pero let's take this opportunity to discuss the matter, no. So with this, no, with the topic that I will be discussing today, I will just cover itong mga specific, no. We go specifically to this following, no. Ano nga ba yung ideal coverage ng mandatory military service, no? Gaano katagal usually, that's the duration of service, meron bang kabayaran, no, meron ba siyang kabayaran yung pagserbisyo mo na yan, no, what are the possible exemption, no, and punishment for those who violate, no, kasi magiging batas yan. So these are the topic that we will be covering, you know, for this matter, no? Now, if you have question, guys, with regards to the thing that we will be discussing today, no, feel free, no, to comment in the comment section. Pwede nating idagdag yan, okay? Okay, so let's talk about the coverage, no? So we tried to compare, no, the different countries that have this mandatory military service, no? Marami kasing bansa, guys, ang nagpapatupad naman talaga ng mandatory military service, no? So, base sa ating nakikita, the usual age, no, bracket ng kanilang minamandate to undergo military service ay nasa 18 to 30 years old, no? Some other countries, no, umaabot yan hanggang 40 years old, no? So, hindi ibig sabihin nito na pag 18 to 30 years old, ay 18 to 30, mag-serve ka sa military. No, no, this is just the duration. Kumbaga, no, pag 18 ka na, no, yan na magsisimula na pwede ka nang i-mandate ng gobyerno na mag-render ng military service, no? With regards to the duration, pag-uusapan naman natin mamaya. Pero parang ganito, no? Okay. So, 18 to 30 kasi the ideal age, no, na pwede pa nating pilitin yung isang tao na mag-render ng military service given the fact that hindi pa kumbaga wala pa masyadong affected when it comes to his personal life, no, when it comes to his career, no, and other matters. So for example, di ba, para pag 18 ka na is kung dati sana sa amin papasok ka pa lang sa college, eh. So you're not yet decided, no, kung ano yung papasukin mo, kumbaga parang ganun, kumbaga nag-iisip ka pa lang kung saan mo gustong pumunta, anong profession yung papasukin mo, something like that. So hindi ka pa established, no? At that time, no, maganda na kumbaga is pumasok na sila kasi they have fewer responsibilities, no? Konti pa lang ang kanilang responsibilidad. And unlike kapag halimbawa 30 plus and above ka na, tendencies are kahit nga 25 and above, no, medyo marami ka ng responsibilities, either may anak ka na, may pamilya ka ng binubuhay, may sariling negosyo ka na, no, may profession ka na, no, something like that. So para hindi apektado itong mga to, no, kasi hindi naman dapat makasarili ang gobyerno, dapat isaalang-alang din nila ang kapakanan ng bawat individual, no. So dapat they choose a specific age bracket na kung saan hindi magkakaroon ng negative or big impact yung pagpunta nila at pag-render ng military service, no, sa kanilang buhay, no. So something like that. So if I went to military service for the age of 18, no, 18, 19, 20, parang ganun, something like that, no. So at least paglabas ko, I am a much more mature individual siguro, given the fact that I trained, no, I joined the army, something like that. So mas maganda 'yon, na mas maaga, no? Mas maaga, mas maganda kasi pag halimbawa nasa 20 and above or 25 and above and even 30 and above, no, eh talagang marami ka ng responsibilidad sa buhay, no? Plus factor pa nito, no, eh pag nasa 18 ka pa lang, no, ay medyo masigla pa ang yung masigla pa ang yung kaisipan, masigla pa ang yung kalusugan, no, masigla pa ang yung pangangatawan, kumbaga bagay na bagay kasi mga physical work, no, inside the military service. So talagang nababagay siya for that matter, no. We cannot go lower naman kasi that would likely a violation of course to the right of juveniles, no, that would be in violation of their human rights as a juvenile. So hindi naman pwedeng ibaba natin, no. So 18 nasa legal age na yan, no, and above. Okay, so okay, take this for example, ah, para ma-illustrate natin the importance of the age bracket. Let's say for example, guys, no, na next year may pasa itong batas na to, may sakatuparan. So kung ngayon, guys, ay wala ka pang lampas ng 30 years old, ano, pwede kang mapilit na mag-render ng military service kasi ang coverage niya is 18 to 30 years old. No? 18 to 30 years old. So at the time, pwedeng hindi ka mag-render, no, ng service 18 years old ka, pero babalikan ka ng batas natin para ikaw ay piliting mag-render ng military service. Like for example, no, 18 years old, you are not physically fit, no, meron kang sakit, meron kang ground to be excused for mandatory military service. No? Halimbawa, sabi mo, tapusin ko muna yung aking pag-aaral, no? Tapusin ko muna yung aking pag-aaral bago ako pumasok sa military. So, tinapos mo for 4 years, no? Natapos mo na siya after 4 years, nakagraduate ka na, no? Pwede ka pa rin singilin ng gobyerno na kung saan is, you still need to render military service, no? So, kumbaga, hanggat hindi pa siya lumalampas ng 30, no? Pwede ka pa rin singilin ng gobyerno. Kaya, yung iba, like for example, in Korea, like for example, in South Korea, no? Wherein, yung mga talagang ayaw mag-render ng military service, ang ginagawa nila, nagtra-travel sila abroad, no? Pumupunta sa mga ibang bansa na walang military service, no? Like here, no? Kaya ang dami-daming Koreano dyan sa Baguio sometimes, no? They are trying to evade itong mandatory military service, no? Babalik na lang sila dun pag nasa mga 30 years old na sila, no? Or above. I think South Korea is kung 35 years old yata yung mandatory hanggang 35. So balik sila doon, paglampas na sila doon sa mandatory age, no? Hindi na sila mapipilit, no? Pero may kaukulang parusa yun which we will be tackling later on, no? So ganun yung mangyayari, no? So balik tayo doon sa example natin kanina, like for example, gusto kong tapusin muna yung pag-aaral ko, so that would like 4 years, no? 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, no? So 22 years old ka na, tapos ka ng pag-aaral mo, pwede ka pa rin bang pilitin? Yes, kasi hindi ka palampas ng 30 years old, no? Parang ganun yung idea, okay? So it would be good, ano, kapag ganyan ang age bracket na, kasi yung iba, kahit 40 years old na pwede pa nilang pilitin. Eh, marami ng ano yun. Marami ng responsibilidad sa buhay, marami ng sakit, no? Eh, instead na mag-servisyo, baka mamaya maging burden pa siya ng organization. So, at least nasa 18 to 30. Okay? So, with regards to the duration, ano, again, as based on the different rules, no, na in-implement ng mga countries na merong mandatory military service, no, ang duration nila usually nagre-range yan sa 1 to 2 years, no? Sometimes it's being counted by months, but apparently that's the approximation. Nasa 1 to 2 years ng military service, depende, no? Kung anong susundin natin kapag halimbawa we try to create our own law, no, mandating military service. So gaano katagal? May iba guys na usually 6 months lang, pero I don't think that's enough. Again, military service ang pinag-uusapan dito. It's not like training. No? It's not like ROTC that is more on training. Ito, talagang military service. So you train, then you apply what you learn on the training. So kasali na yun, guys. No? Halimbawa, 6 months is the period of training and then the rest of the months now will be for the military service. Pwedeng ganun yung mangyari. So depende, guys, kung anong susundin. Ano? Pero sa akin, I think the ideal would be like, ano, 1.5 year, no? So that would likely to be ilang months yun, no, of military service. Bakit? Kasi we need to give time for the training process, no? Dapat bigyan talaga ng oras yung training, then later on give them time also to apply, no, what they had learned during the training process, no? Kasi baka mamaya training lang ang pinag-focusan, then later on wala naman silang application. Hindi nila talaga may internalize kung ano man yung knowledge na in-instill sa kanila during the training process, no? So at least, siguro mga yung 1 year na pag-serve mo, no? 1 year experience mo ng pag-render ng military service, I think that's enough already to instill whatever it is the government that wanted to instill. Like if that's patriotism, discipline, something like that, that's enough already. So siguro nandyan, no? Pwedeng i-adapt yun. But it can no longer, dapat hindi naman siya more than 2 years kasi that would affect, no? That would affect the personal life of that person, professional career of that person. Imagine mo guys, no? Hindi naman talaga niya gusto mag-military pero dahil pinilit mo siyang mag-render ng military service ng more than 2 years, so, wala, no? It is a waste of time on his part since that's not what his profession is all about, no? That's not what his passion all about, no? Kaya nga, no, meron din tayong ano dito. Excuse me. Meron ding provision yung ibang bansa dito na halimbawa ikaw ay ikaw ay college graduate, no? Kapag ikaw ay college graduate, you will be serving the military for a lesser period compared to those who are not college graduate. So if you have like a special skill, like for example in research, you know, you are given consideration also, no? That you will render, no? You will render your military service shorter than what is mandated. So may mga ganong provisions yung ibang bansa, which I think is good. Kasi nga, there are those individuals that are really not interested for in joining, no? They're not passionate in joining military service, no? So they only do that because it's mandatory by the law. So they should be given consideration also, lalo na kung talagang meron naman talaga silang gustong gawin at meron naman talagang ebidensya na may ginagawa nga sila, no, na pwedeng maka-benefit din sa ating bansa. Like for example, if siya ay isang teacher, no? If he is a teacher, no? So why waste the 2 years or more years of that person in military service if it's not really his passion or her passion, no? So maybe you give him a half of the time, no? Oh, sige, since it's mandatory, no, you serve the military for 1 year, then you may already exit, no? Pwede ka nang bigyan ng yes. Pwede ka nang bigyan ng discharge certificate, something like that. So may mga provisions na nabinibigay ang ibang bansa dito, no? And I do hope, no, that if our country would also create our own with this, no, they would give due consideration also to those professionals na talagang are doing something also for the benefit of the country, no? And they would be given consideration too, no? Like yung mga inventor, di ba? Yung mga scientist, something like that. So sayang naman kung uubusin nila yung oras nila doon sa military service instead of them doing something that is much more valuer, no? than fulfilling what the law mandates, no? So there should be a consideration that will be given to this also, no? With regards to the duration, no? Okay? Yeah. So with regards to compensation, ano, I think this is one of the issue that you will raise, no? Sir, paano naman yung bayad? Alam nga namang hindi kami sumweldo kung parehas din naman yung sinasakripisyo namin. And how would that be different para sa mga voluntary personnel talaga? Talagang nag-apply for that profession, ano? So, this is what we had observed, no? Some countries had actually provide, no? Not compensation, but it is like an allowance, no? Parang allowance lang siya. No? Hindi naman ganun kalakihan, no? Kasi nga, remember that it is still mandatory, no? Kumbaga sa pilitan, okay? Now, considering also the risk that they're putting in, no? Yung mga magre-render ng military service, eh, may kailangan din nila ng konting allowance, no? They will be given, or they should be given actually an allowance, no? Not that much, but at least something that is worth it naman and humane, no? Kasi after military service, di ba? Halimbawa, if hindi ako pumasok sa military service, in that 2 years, no, I could have earned this much of money. Parang ganun, di ba? Kung wala ako dito, syempre, kumita din sana ako para sa pamilya ko, para sa sarili ko, para sa kinabukasan ko, something like that. So, it is just right and proper naman to give compensation for these individuals who would be rendering military service even if it is mandatory, ano? So, may mga ganun. And I think it depends upon the rank, no? Kasi may mga ranking system din sila even for this matter, no? So sometimes there those college graduates are giving privilege to hold a higher rank compared to those non college graduate or non degree holder, something like that, no? So with that, it has an effect also to the compensation that they are receiving, no, or allowance that they are receiving in their military service, no? So it's just right and proper, and I think this is one of the consideration that the country should give also, no, when it comes to this. I think one of the issues na sinite nila, no, as stated by General Delfin Lorenzana, if I'm sure, na basta parang narinig ko na sabi niya is costly, no, mahal, no, mahal ang gagamitin kasi we know for a fact na kailangan magtayo ng training centers, no, hindi naman ganun karami ang mga camp, training camp, no, ng military sa ating bansa. So they need to create, no, new training camp, no, they need to delegate, no, new personnels. But if we're going to look on the long-term effect of this, it would be very beneficial actually, no? Kasi, una, pwedeng mabawasan natin yung expenses ng ating gobyerno when it comes to the issues of juvenile delinquency, no? Kasi, I know, mababawasan yung juvenile delinquency dito, ano, pag nagkaroon ng ganito. Kasi, we would be having more disciplined individuals, no? Especially for juveniles, youth, and so on. And then, this is usually where the criminal career of those individuals, especially kung nag-start sila mag-pickpocket, yung mga juvenile delinquents, no? May transition period yan eh. Usually, tumataas or nagpipick yung kanilang criminal career at the age of 18 to 30. No? Diyan yung peak niya. So, pwede nating mapigilan yan if we would try to recruit them and make them or the, give them the, I mean, you mandate them to render military service, something like that. So, kumbaga, pwedeng may mga mapigilan tayo na instead na mag-turn siya into criminal and because of this military service, eh, mag-serve siya, he could learn the doctrine, he could learn the discipline inside, something like that. So, pwede nating mapigilan yun, ano? So, that would be a good program for the issues on criminality. Pwede nating mabawasan yan. And, no? There was a study that this is actually cost-effective, no? Although you are going to spend much money or budget, no, building or creating facilities, no, delegating personnel, something like that. But consider the fact that kapag meron ka ng mga individuals, no, who are serving the nation, I mean, mandatorily, no, they will not receive the same salary that those voluntary personnels are receiving, pero, no, they will be rendering service that equals to that. No? So, mas marami ka ng tao ngayon, mas marami ka ng personnel, mas konti, kumbaga, yung ginagasto mo when it comes to sahod kasi walang sweldo. It's just like an allowance. So, mas tipid siya, no? Ganyan yung pwede nating tignan dito. And then, mas marami ng personnel, no? Mas marami ng tao na pwede mong i-delegate sa ganito, no? Kasi the military service is not limited to combat activities lang naman. Hindi lang naman puro parilan, something like that. May mga civil works din sila. Like for example, information dissemination, no? Checkpoint, no? Visitation, ano pa? Medical services, no? And other form of services rendered by the military. So mas dadami pa ngayon sila. No? And I think that would be much more beneficial in the long run compared to what we are going to use, no, or what resources we are going to distribute, no, during the implementation or during the start up of the program, no, kung sakali. So yeah, no, but I think really we need to consider the finances for this, no. The government really need to consider the finances for this before they would decide to implement this. And I know naman that that would be the job of the Congress, ano? But we are just trying to expect something, no? Ine-speculate lang natin kung ano dapat yung pagtuunan ng pansin na once that this will be implemented. So hindi bara-bara na basta, oh sige, mandatory military service, ganito ganyan, no? Let's try to look also on the other aspect of that, no? Ano nga ba yung mga technicalities of this matter, no? And how it will affect also our life, no, and our government. Now, with regards to exemption, ano, kasi hindi pwede naman talagang generally require, no, you require all of them to undergo military service, no? So, there are some qualified exemption naman for this. Like, for example, meron talaga siyang medical, meron siyang medical reason, valid medical reason why he cannot join the military service, no? So, kung may sakit siya na talagang makaka-apekto naman, no, sa kanyang physical health, no, something like that, so he will not be required to join the military service, no. Or kung upon evaluation meron siyang mga psychological or mental problems, no, na pwedeng makaapekto sa kanya, no, basta upon proper evaluation, no, he will not be drafted to join or to render military service. Kasi even though we are mandating individuals, no, hindi dapat natin talagang ipilit kung talagang hindi pwede. No, like for example, meron siyang sakit. Like halimbawa, he is physically disabled. So wala nga naman pilitin mo yan, no? He is suffering from mental problem, no? You would not, no? Huwag mo siyang pilitin kasi that would not benefit the force, no? That would not benefit the country, for that matter, no? Makakasama lang siya actually. Religion, no? I hope you watch the movie, no? Ano? I forgot the title, no? Basta si Desmond, no? So, if you can remember, no? There was a movie na nakalimutan ko lang yung title, no? Pa-comment nga. So there was this movie na kung saan is the character named Desmond, no? He doesn't want to join the military force, no? Required sa kanila ang military service pero ayaw niya talaga, no? Based on his religion kasi talagang bawal. So, because of the mandate na kailangan talaga nilang sumali, and perhaps yung tatay niya rin kasi sa former soldier, yung kapatid niya pumasok na doon, siya na lang hindi, no? So napilitan siya with the idea that he would not be forced to hold firearms, something like that, no? So ayun, if you watch the movie you can relate actually, no? Hindi na natin ikwekwento yung buong movie. So some religion kasi really disbar yung mga ganitong ideas like yung barbaric action like killing, no, so talagang bawal sa kanilang religion. And I think, no, the country should also respect that kasi we know for a fact that meron naman talagang mga ganung bagay that we should look into, no. So religion can be an exemption also, no. Other socially approved reasons such as for example yan, yung bata, no, I encountered this, nabasa ko sa isang ano, I think that's in Egypt, no, na kapag yung bata is the only, if yung child, I mean if yung individual was the only child of the family, no, kaisa-isang he would not be required to render military kasi kaisa-isa na nga, di ba? Paano kung mapahamak pa siya doon sa military. So wala na, no, wala nang tagapagmana ng ang kanila, no, wala nang tagapagmana ng kanilang apelyido and so on, something like that. So meron naman yung mga certain iba pa, no, sa ibang bansa naman, like in I think that's in Israel, no, pag member ka ng LGBT you're not required, you are actually exempted to join the military forces. So this depends upon what the society wants to accept, no? Depending upon the moral and social norms of the society, meron silang pwedeng i-exempt, no? Na kung saan it is commonly agreed, no? Mga ganon. So pwede pa silang magdagdag dito, depende, no? Pero dapat ma-establish ito ng ating batas. So, kung sakaling gagawin nga nila, no, dapat magkaroon talaga ng option, no? Exemption to this matter. Kasi alam naman natin, ano, we're gonna just implement something that is absolute. No, hindi naman dapat totally, this is the rule, no? And no exemption to everyone. So dapat meron talagang exemption for this, no? At isa yun sa dapat tignan natin. Kung wala siyang exemption, ako, delikado po yan, no? Kung wala siyang, walang alternative, no? Delikado po yan, no? So those are the things that we should look into, no? In this new proposal that the Vice President aspirant Sara Duterte had construed, no, as part of her advocacy, no, whenever she will be elected as the Vice President of our country, no. And for me, as I've stated, I agree, I get the idea, no, it's good, no, as long as, okay, there should be a clear discussion on what is inclusive on that mandate, no? Sabi nga natin, sometimes, no, the program could be good. That happens to ROTC. Kaya daming bumabatik ko sa ROTC, no? Kasi the idea of ROTC is actually good, but the problem is the implementation, na nawawala kasi yung purpose niya minsan. So that's what I worry about this also, no? I see the potential, no, of this, no, to our country, nation building, to criminality in our profession, criminology. I see the potential of this, no, when it happens. But at the same time, I can see also the possible risk of this. The once it goes to the wrong people, no, pwede kasing maabuso na naman ito, gaya ng nangyari sa ROTC, something like that. So yun yung iniiwasan natin, no? And I do hope that once this will be implemented, no, dapat klaro lahat yung mga provisions niya, no, at public consultation, something like that, no? And then the implementation should be really supervised, kasi this is like a double-edged weapon that we're holding. It could benefit us, no, but it could destroy us also, as this could be the source of abuse also if not properly supervised. And lastly, you know, how would this affect now our profession, especially criminology, no? Kasi pag PNPA, PMA, it will not affect them. Kasi I think if they would adopt the same, no, as Brazil, no? Sa Brazil kasi if you are nasa service ka na, like pasok ka sa PNPA, pasok ka sa PMA, you are not required to run your mandatory military service kasi doon ka papunta eh, no? For those, no, nag-undergo ng police training, no, so halimbawa nasa law enforcement field ka na, you are not required to render military service. Pero sa criminology may problema, no, kasi we know for a fact that criminology profession, no, majority of those who enroll criminology profession really goes into law enforcement, but that does not make enrolling in criminology as an exemption, no? Hindi porket nag-enroll ka na ng criminology so you will be exempted to military service, because this is not a police training academy, no? This is not police training academy. It is a bachelor's degree, no? It's different from PNPA, PMA program, no? So I think this is where the problem will rise now for us, a criminology profession, no? So unless, no, our board, no, of criminology will make something, no, that will halimbawa na isa batas na, no, that will make, no, those who are enrolling criminology exempted for rendering military service kasi doon naman sila papunta, no, that would give, no, new life to criminology profession, no, lalago siya lalo. But if not, no, if not, kung hindi mangyayari yun, I think it could negatively impact, no, the criminology profession. Kasi nga, why would you enroll BS criminology, no, with the aim of going joining the PNP, no, if you could just avail the mandatory military service training and you could gain experience from that, and possibly there could be a provision under the mandatory military service that if, no, nag-render ka na, natapos mo na yung mandatory period, no, you could either choose to be discharged or to continue, no, with your service. So nandun ka na, no? So why would you, ano, bakit kapag gasto ng pera for 4 years studying BS criminology plus another 1 year for board examination, tapos isang katutak na proseso sa pag-a-apply para makapasok ko sa PNP, if pwede mo siya i-shortcut joining the mandatory military service, no, and, no, giving your full intention that you desire to continue, no, serving the military service, no, even if you are longer done with your mandatory service. So parang ganun, no? So yun yung pwede nating makitang possibilities with regards to this, ano. I would agree with the idea, but of course, no, for criminology profession we should look into this thing also, how could we able to protect also our profession, kasi pag nagkataon na libre na ang pumasok, no, sa kasundaluhan, then that would make, no, the criminology profession like non-ideal, kumbaga, diba? Kasi if they will receive the same benefit, no, kapag nag full time na sila, if they become a voluntary personnel already of the Philippine Army or what companies that, no, pwedeng mangyari to, no, pwedeng ganito, ganun yung maging epekto niya, no, at makakasama yun sa industriya ng criminology. But again, no, I think what's important is the country, no. Pero I think, no, the Board of Criminology should take into consideration this also, no, yung mga pinapoint out natin. Once that nagkaroon na nga ng movement to make a law, no, creating or mandating military service, okay? So, for punishment naman, kasi hindi tayo pwedeng gumawa ng batas, lalo it's mandatory if there's no punishment. So, question is, meron bang punishment para doon sa mga tumatakas, no, or ayaw mag-serve ng military service, okay? So, meron guys, for other countries, they usually fine, no, nagpapumulta sila, no, medyo may kalakihan din ng multa, or hindi naman kaya is a combination of imprisonment, no. Usually, ang pagkakulong is like, 3 years, ganun. 3 years, ang 3 years imprisonment plus fine, no? Something like that. Meron din, no? Yung mga tumatakas sa mga ganyan are given bad moral character. Ayan. So, pag tumakas ka, no? You cannot be able to apply in public position, no? Sa government. Kasi, some countries requires their certificate of completing mandatory military service before employment. So, may mga ganun, ano? So, na, kumbaga, they are being discriminated by the fact that they did not render military service. So, those are some of the punishment that the government could adapt, no? In order to really mandate, no? Para bigyan ng ngipin yung mandato that they would require military service for every individual, no? Yan. So, as long as it's humane, no? Then I think we're good into it, no? But consider those fact, no? Mag-agree lang tayo kung papabor, no? Nga sa mga sa ating karapatang pantao, yung magiging provisions ng magiging batas na ito once na may sakatuparan nga yung paggawa ng batas that mandates military service, okay? So I think that's it, no? Yun muna, napahaba actually ang ating talakayan pagdating sa topiko na ito, no? So if you have question, no, for this topic, no, you can comment on the comment section. You can comment on our Facebook page, no. Please support also our Facebook page, no, kasi pinupost din natin yung mga upload natin sa YouTube doon sa ating Facebook page, no. I think mas madaling manood sa Facebook page kaya nilalagay din natin siya doon, no. So continue subscribing and sharing our lectures, no. Thank you very much all for your support. If you find this interesting and educational, no, please share. Thank you, and yan muna sa ngayon, guys. So sorry na medyo formal, no, medyo hindi maganda yung pakiramdam natin. Ayan guys, so yun muna sa ngayon, no. See you on the next lecture. Bye bye.